Hello, my name is Inger. I am a Norwegian person who lives in Japan and does music and art and other things as well. There, intro out of the way. And now I am about to tell you guys out there, probably, that you don't know me very well. Unless you follow my English Twitter, I do tend to drunk tweet a lot over there, and the truth tends to come out, however jumbled. But let's pretend that doesn't exist. So, you guys probably don't know me very well, so you don't know that I'm kinda terrible. You see, how do I explain this? I don't actually think that it's all that unique of a problem. I spent more than a year touring a lot and meeting a lot of new people, like multiple groups of new people a week, other bands that we would play alongside with, and a lot of the time I didn't get much time to talk to each of them, especially because I'm shy, and it didn't help that certain people were doing their best to convince me that I was a terrible person and people who generally thought that I was rude and awful. So on top of all of that, also, my memory is for shit. I'm already not great at remembering which names go with which faces, and I am doing my best to remedy that now. Always in my life, repeating all the names like 3 times when I first hear them and, you know, all of the tricks. Because that's just, you know, that's just actually rude and awful, right? To like not remember people's names. But my point is, I have kind of just had to make peace with the fact that now in my life I'm going to meet a lot of people who know exactly who I am, and I will not know exactly who they are, but I will have to do my damnedest while talking to them to remember, you know, where we first met and what the circumstances were and all of that stuff while pretending that I do know all of that stuff. So, I don't know, do you understand what I mean? So with the title of this video and everything, you probably know exactly where this is going. This is in recent times with the band that I'm in now, the number zero, when we were doing a show in Nagoya, and I'm sitting at the merch booth, and it's before the venue opens, and this dude, a very handsome boy, I have to say, at the next booth is talking to me and being very familiar, like, what have you been up to lately, how are you doing, how are things with your new band, kind of personal questions, I guess. And I do my shtick, answer, pretend to know exactly who he is and where we have previously met, but it's not really coming to me. Not until like fully hours later when I realize he's my ex-boyfriend. We fully dated for like a few months. And if you are now thinking, damn Inger, you date so many boys you can't even keep track of them, you are thinking too highly and too lowly of me at the same time. I have not had that many actual boyfriends, and with each actual relationship, I have gone into it with serious intent. Not like I want to marry them right from the start or anything, because, you know, that's a little crazy. But, like, if I'm dating somebody, I'm committed. Like, we are boyfriend and girlfriend. I don't play around. That's just not my game. It helps, of course, that I don't have game. Makes it easier. But so here comes the part where I can't really say defend myself, because I fully admit that this is pretty terrible. But here comes the part where I at least try to explain myself. So this relationship started out, again, committed. In the beginning, it was pretty romantic. Even we would go places. He even took me to Yokohama Arena to see One Ok Rock, which to me is a really awesome gesture, something that I could never be able to afford myself. We would go on actual dates and go nice places and stuff. And then kind of just petered out rather fast to where we would just hang out at the same mall all the time, looking at the same clothes, and mind you, always clothes for him, for whatever reason, never for me. He'd never come with me to a store that I wanted to go to. And then we would go to his house and hang out in his room, watching Paramore music videos. At least it's good music, you know, but I mean, that does get repetitive fast. a lot of the time he just falls asleep even, and I don't want to give him any shit for that because he was working nights. But you see what I mean? I think if he was having fun, you know, he would probably would have been able to stay awake most of the time. The most interesting thing about hanging out together started being when his dad would make us dinner, because, like, he was a chef, and we would hang out with his parents for a bit and eat, and his parents were pretty great. Except for that, we would only meet if one of us went to the other person's concert, which isn't a great couple activity in Japan. I might just make a whole video about that one of these days, and you'll see what I mean. But for now, just trust me. So, we started seeing less and less of each other. We didn't live super close or anything. He lived in Yokohama, and I lived in a shit little student town, which is why I would always go to his place, and he'd never come to mine, even though, you know, I didn't live with my parents, and there was more freedom at my house. But at this point, we were both pretty busy, and we weren't really meeting very much at all. And I can't tell you exactly what he was feeling, of course, but I'm going to assume it was something similar to how I was feeling, which was not much, to be honest. Like, I didn't miss him. I didn't feel the need to hang out. But I also hate breaking up with people, and since I wasn't really interested in anyone else at the moment, I guess I felt I didn't need to break up with him, which sounds pretty weird now that I say it out loud. But so every now and then, I would send him a text being like, hey, how are you? How was your day? Stuff like that. Because I'm committed, damn it. And that's kind of the bare minimum you can do when you're in a relationship, right? Which, no, actually, if that's all the effort you can muster, you probably shouldn't be in your relationship. But it wasn't just me, okay? If anything, he was making even less of an effort than I was. And, well, that was until he finally did the right thing and answered one of those very lackluster texts with, hey, I'm sorry, but would you be okay with going back to just being friends? Which, yes, I was very, very okay with that indeed. If anything, that's the happiest he'd probably made me since that one o'clock show. So, as you can see, the relationship just kind of fizzled out, which is probably the only time in my life that that's ever happened to me. I've had my share of dramatic fucking endings, and after this one, I actually did have a very dramatic, I might even say traumatic and somewhat life-defining thing with someone I actually met through him. But after him and me were finished, alright? Committed, remember? None of these things, though, excuses completely forgetting about a handsome and talented and nice person that I was, you know, pretty intimate with at one point. And please know that I am working on my shitty memory to my best ability. I really, really hope telling this story haven't made you hate me. But I think I'll end it there for now. And I'll talk to you again later. Please do check out my links in the description to my band and to, like, my other stuff if you're interested in my art, and you can follow me on other social media places where I will upload more of it. And please give this video a like, that would help me out so much, unless you hate me now. I hope you don't. Bye.